afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining today. And you have heard a lot of information about innovation. And as you can see, right, there is, you must have heard, there is no way forward without innovation, right? Without innovation, there is no way forward. And if you look at even the whole event, we had to innovate quite a bit compared to what how it has been going on for all these years. I think finally we landed on a hybrid model. And after we looked into quite a bit of depth, I think we can do a fantastic event even on the virtual side and then on the hybrid together, right? So, so you heard a little bit about how the virtual event would be. And we spent a lot of time looking into it. I think it all came upon us quite suddenly, what this whole COVID situation in the last several months. And when we started planning for it a few months ago, we were preparing for what could be the worst situation, meaning we may not be in a position to, you know, have a real physical event like before, which had been done very grandly over the last several years. But then we said, okay, we have to innovate, right? I think we have to think about what is out there. And though we have not done this before in a virtual format, then we deliberated and we said, okay, we'll try to do a mix of it, right? I think one, we do a virtual and then a hybrid kind of a model with at least some element of physical thing in the evening. But then it is also from an innovation point of view, you have to think, okay, how do you really do this virtual event, right? Do you go ahead and start building software for it? Do you do it with Zoom? Do you do it with any of the existing things that are typically used in a corporate and education setting or the meeting that we have now? Or are there some other opportunities available that you can do an event as much like a real physical event and are there other product solutions out there? Surprisingly enough, we found there are a number of such offerings that are available. Right, I think we, and then though this particular technology industry had been there for some time, it had caught on quite a bit. And there were products that were coming out new and there were existing products completely coming up with new innovations, new capabilities, and to an extent, pretty much anything and everything that you can do in a physical sort of an environment, from a lobby to registration to, you know, having a main speaker event to booths and then, you know, delegates to be able to socialize with each other, having the ability to meet with the media. Pretty much we found everything was there, and we looked at a number of options and we have finalized on a technology solution that I think would work very, very well. And one of the benefits that we found was, you know, okay, yes, there are limitations, we cannot do something physical, but then a virtual event also brings in a lot of other advantages, right? You don't have the physical setting as a constraint for people to, you know, come and be there in a physical place. I think now you can open it for much larger audience all over the world. Not only that, in terms of speakers and panel, now the reach is a lot more, right? I think you don't have to be constrained whether somebody can travel or not, whether they are physically available. Now the reach is a lot more. So what you will see as a result is, I think you have heard quite a bit from Barani and Karan in terms of the event itself and the list of speakers and the panels. I think you will find it one of the very rich events in terms of what, compared to even what we have done in the last several years. So we're all looking forward to it. So talking a little bit more on the train of thought on the innovation, there are several areas I see a focus on. One of the areas is, you know, we have a forum called Innovation Forum. Our large charter is continue to enhance the innovation ecosystem in Hyderabad, right? And as part of it, we work obviously very closely with the industry, with academia, and with of course the government, and also with the community, right? And there are several things some of you would have seen that we have done in the past, which is like, you know, webinars, workshops, series through the TVs, and we have had some where a lot of startup series, I mean, founders coming and talking to the audience, larger audience. There are so many of these things that happen in the context of knowledge sharing. Another area of focus that we do is, you know, partnerships with different organizations. One of the organizations we partnered with, the STPI, in terms of, you know, computer vision programs and startups supporting them. Right? And one of the other areas we are actively working on is centers of excellence, cloud center of excellence being one that we are expecting to launch very soon. So the Innovation Forum has a number of key priorities as such. One of the two important areas that we focus on is called social innovation, right? I think social innovation, which is technology for good. And in that context, what we are also doing this year is a hackathon, right? So what we have launched is about a few weeks ago, we have launched a hackathon that is open to the member companies of HICEA, that is the industry, which is focused on technology for good, that is social innovation. And technology for good, we kind of opened up to sustainable goals, right? I think many of you would have been familiar with sustainable development goals. There are 17 goals that UN has identified. So what we said is, we don't want to prescribe, go ahead and solve this problem. There are a number of problems out there, and we opened up the problem space to the industry and said, okay, you come and pick a problem of your choice, come and build some prototypes as part of the hackathon. And not only that, we would want to recognize the winners. What we are also interested in doing is, if the, based on the ideas, we want to take it forward, put some more industry backing into it, volunteering into it, and maybe make it a lot more real and impactful in the community. Okay, this is a larger intent around the hackathon. It is not just a coding competition. It is more about idea generation, more about solving real problems in the community, doing good through technology, and then having a longer impact even beyond this awards and recognition at this point of time. Okay, so we look forward to, actually we are looking forward to seeing all the outcome of the hackathon and the results and everything else that will probably show up in the next few days. And maybe as, and we plan to announce the winners as part of the event on November 5th.